Without water, we all die. The lake has had some problems. It's suffered, but it can be fixed.
As you drive outside of Utah County, you go to the next valley, there's not a lake, and the next valley, and the next valley.
Utah Lake, it's the reason why people moved here in the first place and provided resources, food, and water for all of the valley. And then when it became damaged, people kind of turned their backs on it.
I am the seventh generation farmer. My grandparents and my parents, we've all lived here on the lake, and so we've seen the transformation from buffaloes, elk, and deer to dairy farms and farmers on the lakeshore to now urban development and housing.
It has a very large watershed, almost 3,000 square miles. 600,000 people live in that watershed. Everything that we do is moving downstream. It has an impact on Utah Lake.
We've been in the midst of scientific research on Utah Lake for decades. It's very unique. There's wetlands and meadows and ponds, streams, and beautiful shoreline. It should have blooms 365 days a year, but because of that shallowness and the wind and turbidity, it defies all odds.
One of the most important attributes of Utah Lake is its resilience. Most lake ecosystems, if you gave them the amount of human pressure that Utah Lake receives, they would be in very bad and getting worse state. In contrast, Utah Lake is actually on the road to recovery because of 50 years of concerted restoration efforts.
It's made a roaring comeback. You know, when you look back 15 years ago, everyone was running away from the lake. Right now, everyone's fighting for the lake. Everyone wants a piece of it. Everyone is willing to come to the table and invest in it.
The June Sucker Recovery Implementation Program, conservation of wetlands around the lake, nutrient removal from wastewater treatment plants. There are all these projects that are ongoing.
Change on a lake this size is almost always incremental. Even if you really ramp up investment, but maybe you speed it up a little bit, maybe instead of centuries or decades, you can compress some of the restoration outcomes to just a number of years. But it definitely takes time and effort.
Ecological restoration is a lot like medicine. And in medicine, it can be tempting to say, hey, I've got a miracle pill. If you take that, that's going to give you health. We know that's not true. True health comes from long-term positive behaviors, treating the cause, not just the symptoms of these issues. We need to continue what we've been doing.
We see studies all over the world of mismanaged lakes, and we see failed projects. We don't want Utah Lake to become one of those.
I think the arrogance of the past problems of the lake was allowing one voice to be heard. We have to be humble enough to understand that there's a lot of different voices. We've got to have robust scientific debate on the lake. That takes time.
Grassroots restoration projects generally are better because people are familiar with the land, they know the land, they have been there, they've experienced it.
The decisions being made aren't for today. They're gonna carry on through the generations. My mother tells stories about grandma being out here, and that was just a way of life. You Everybody gets together, you go out, you catch fish. The children were learning while all of this was taking place right here on these shores. Things are different now. There's other people here. They should have the privilege of enjoying this lake also.